This is the 77 Blazers podcast show. I'm your host, Mike Doherty. This was a big, big game in terms of Shaedon Sharpe, but also you don't want to lose to the Houston Rockets, who are 1-5 with your leader down. And the Blazers stepped up, beat the Rockets handily, and showed the debut of Shaedon Sharpe. Joe Cronin made a great pick in the draft. Ant showed up. Everybody showed up. Nurk showed up. Let's get right into the highlights, and then we'll go to some post game with Bo Dizzy. But right before we go to the highlights, I would like to announce a T-shirt, Shaq of Troutdale. Drew Eubanks, who was hopping around dunking the ball tonight against the Rockets. It's at redbubble.com. Purple Peppers T-shirt design. I put it down in the link. Click on that link and get yourself a Shaq of Troutdale T-shirt number 24, Drew Eubanks. All right, let's get right into the highlights here on the 77 podcast show. Blazers versus the Houston Rockets. We're going to see a lot of Nurk, and we're going to see a lot of Shaedon Sharpe. All right, this Nurk's on a smaller guy, but he's going to do an awkward off-balance kick his heels up and shoot it. Now, Nurk's on a smaller guy right here, but yet he still lays it in off of this turnaround, which is fine. But this is what he should be doing right here. Every game, bam, dunk. He should be the field goal percentage leader. Not doing stuff like that, but he got it back. He's the biggest guy in the court. I love Nurk, but he needs to use... He could be the Bosnian beast. He could be throwing it down every game, but he does stuff like that. He sometimes thinks he's a point guard. Or now a shooting guard at the top for shooting for three. Nurk needs to just come strong like this right here. He's going to back him down and then throw it down. That's what I want to see from Nurkic. The Bosnian beast every game. That's what I want to see. Good job, Nurk.
Beautiful release. Yeah. Nothing but net.
Or fearful of... Green slaps it outside here. Sharpe the other way. Cox it and rocks a right-hand slam on the run.
Here's Nurkic backing down. Drop step spin goes up and under. Nope. Tapped up. Shaedon Sharpe made it look easy. Grant working on Knicks. Swerves, double team spots a cutter. Sharpe up top. A windmill jackhammer for Shaedon Sharpe on a terrific setup from Grant, who knows something about going airborne. Oh, Dame wants to see the replay. So does the crowd. Delayed reaction from the crowd, the echo reverberating. Here's a loose ball. Keon Johnson runs it down. Who's trailing? It's Sharpe! Sharpe was trailing for the two-hand jam. An explosion of energy, enthusiasm.
All right, please welcome the 77 podcast show, Bo Dizzy. This is what we talked about earlier, right after the game. All right, game reaction against the Houston Rockets and Portland Trailblazers at home. Portland takes the win. Instant post-game reaction with Bo. And I want to clarify this. Is it Dizzy or Dizzy?
It's it depends. Potatoes, up, down, north, south. You choose. Bo Dizzy.
Dizzy.
Whatever you're comfortable with.
Bo Dizzy.
It's not like I'm going to say, hey, only my mother calls me Bo whatever this way or that way. So you choose.
All right. So we both watched the game, and we both were taking notes. This was a big game for Portland in the sense of Dame was gone, and they're also playing a one-win Rockets team, so you could let yourself down and get blown out, which they did not. What did you see in tonight's game, and specifically, were you watching or following anybody?
I was interested in just seeing how the coach would throw them out there, the new lineup, obviously. At some point, they were going to try and showcase Shaedon Sharpe, which they did early, and he looked great. I mean, what can you say about this guy? He's coming along very fast. Looks excellent. Looks like an NBA player. Been in the league for years already. So, yeah, I just wanted to see what they would do. Like you said, you know, you can let yourself down easy with a team like the Rockets. But, you know, I got to tip my cap to the coach who early on in the game went inside. Nurk had had a great start, had a great game, obviously. And then Eubanks late in that first quarter, had a nice little run into the second quarter, and pounding it inside against a team like Houston, that's just good coaching.
Yeah, word on the street coming out of Portland, had a few people text me when I said Sharp rumor on word on the street Sharp is going to start, and then I got a bunch of texts back saying I think they're just going to throw the ball down into Nurk, which had me ick. You know, you should. He's the tallest. He's a big guy. My problem with Nurk is he never dunks the ball. This is the NBA. You can't lay it in. You're gonna get blocked, which he did a few times tonight. But I think Lamar Hurd during the broadcast, I learned how to switch back and forth to home and away announcing on the NBA app. Lamar Hurd brought up that this is Nurk's pace, you know. It's not he could slow down and kind of have his way in the middle, and he did. He had a great game. I'm going to look at the stats. He double-double with, I think, 12, 15 rebounds and 27 points. So, I mean, he was the biggest guy out there. But as far as other games, he just needs to get out of his head and just play. He could be the beast. He could be the Bosnian beast if he wanted to be. And just dominate like Shaq, but he doesn't. He gets in his head. He slows down.
To me, Nurk is—it's all about the matchup with Nurk, who he's going up against. Obviously, tonight Houston, Şengün didn't offer much resistance. And number one over there in Houston, their third overall pick this year. I tell you what, he looks like a ball player.
Yeah,
looks like he needs a little more seasoning, but. Keep your eye on him because definitely something to look at in the future. But going back to Nurk, he just had his way. When he goes up against someone bigger, who knows? But tonight was just a very favorable matchup for him.
Yeah, I'm glad he showed up and played well. I think on one of our past shows, Chauncey Billups during post game talks about Nurk quite a bit. Once he's focused on the game, he's in it. And if he's not, he gets out. But coach knows when to take him out and when to play him. I also had watching the game. I saw, you know, Jeremy Grant was not vocal, but he looks like he was having a good time and kind of just leading on the floor by his play. Didn't have to be rah rah, get in your face. It just seemed like, hey man, we're playing hoops. Let's have a good time. I'm going to do my thing. I'm going to move the ball around. Do you have any thoughts, or did you? What do you think about Jeremy Grant so far in the? I think the fifth game.
Absolutely. Ever since he came into the league, I always kept my eye on Jeremy Grant. Always liked him. Hard to take your eyes off him from a basketball fan perspective. He's just long. He's smooth. He does what you want him to do. He's got the right demeanor out there. So when the Blazers got him, I was pretty pumped because he's always been a favorite of mine. For the games that I've seen him play with the Blazers, I find him much more effective when he puts the ball on the ground, drives to the hoop, looks around, or gets the shot himself. Sometimes he can get any shot he wants, just with that length. And a couple of plays tonight, the big play to Shaden when he had his monster dunk early, the first of the series of two. That was a product of Jeremy Grant driving, putting his head down. When he stands outside and waits for a three, when he takes that three, I'm not saying he can't make it or he doesn't want to make it, but to me, on a team like the Blazers, you leave that shot up to Simons. You leave that shot up to Dame. You do what you do well, get close, and see what kind of damage you can cause. I think that's the best that Jeremy Grant can do for us. And I love him. Look forward to seeing him play all season.
All right. During the broadcast, we had Lamar Hurd talk about Gary Payton II making his return pretty soon. Tonight we saw a heavy dose of Justice Winslow bringing up the ball and controlling the offense. I saw during the game that Keon Johnson was playing well, but not handling the ball. I was kind of surprised about that. What are we going to see? Is GP2 going to handle the ball?
Yeah, this is just another thing that's exciting to look forward to from this Blazer team. Every night you're going to get a new look, especially with this rotating health schedule that they're on. So when GP2 comes in, it'll definitely be interesting to see where he is. For me, for my money, he's like a two or a small three. where you want them to crash the boards, get offensive rebounds, steal, sneak up on people, block, just do the little things. And another selfless player on this team. So I'm not sure if he's going to bring up the ball or handle the ball much. Back to your point about Justice and Keon Johnson. I do like Keon Johnson a lot. I do think he can handle the ball. I like the way he plays. He's rough. He's hard-nosed. And, yeah, I look forward to seeing him in the rotation a little bit more too. Again, we touched on Justice Winslow last week a little bit. And, again, I just don't think he's the answer. I just don't see it. Nice piece, but for me, I'd like to see someone else absorb those minutes.
All right, Bo DZ. This is the Only in Portland segment. Go ahead.
Only in Portland tonight before the game. They had the game ball at the very top of the rafters, and the fans sent the ball down one by one. They handed the ball to the person in front of them. Little kids touched the ball. Strangers touched the ball. Everyone touched the ball. I was thinking to myself, wouldn't it just be easier to pass the ball to the front? But no, that was not the point of it. So only in Portland could everyone touch the ball and a super spreader event occurs.
Super spreader ball. All right, Bo DZ, thank you for joining the show after the incredible debut of Shaedon Sharpe. Up next, we have Memphis on the 2nd, and then back-to-back Phoenix in the 4th and the 5th. Do you have any last words when we sign off here?
Couple of tough games, back-to-back, exciting. Like I said earlier, it's always a new adventure with this team, getting to watch every play. I'm looking forward to Wednesday and Thursday.
All right, that's our show for tonight. We'll be back, I think, on Tuesday, November 2nd, in Memphis Grizzlies, and they got back-to-back to the Phoenix Suns. And until then, enjoy the Shaedon Sharpe highlights. And again, get Shaq of Troutdale t-shirt at redtobubble.com. Check out the link below. Subscribe, do all that stuff. Do all that crazy stuff that you do on YouTube. This is the 77 Podcast Show. Thanks for visiting.
Cool, but listen, bro, all I got to say is the Blazers finally got some redemption for Jordan and Sam Bowie because they have the NBA's next superstar.
Shaedon Sharpe.
Fucking kid is better than everybody.